Hey, this is Glenn from Kite Foiling. Today we're going to talk about strutless kites. If you like the content, leave a like on Facebook. Just search for Kite Foiling. I will have a review about the Gong strutless kites, the V2. And I will compare it to the Cloud C5 8.5 meters. So you might wonder, so why are you comparing it to the C5 and not to the latest model, the D? The Cloud D is available. Well, that's due to the simple fact that I'm from Europe and I'm not able to order the clouds into Europe. Greg only ships to the US because he wants to have the full support and the quality that he wants to deliver. And I fully respect that. But if you're from Europe, well, you might have a problem if you want to get your hands on the clouds. This is also a reason why I'm comparing the Gong kite, because many times I get the question, could the Gong strutless kite be a good alternative for the cloud kites? Just one side note, I don't have a shop, I don't sell kites, I don't make any money, I don't work for Gong, I don't work for Boat Riding Maori, I just want to share this information with the community. So let's have a look at the weight of the kite. The cloud kite weighs 1.6 kilos. The Gong kite weighs 2.2 kilos. Obviously, we are comparing the 9 meter with the 8.5 meter. So let's say that the Gong kite is half a kilo heavier than the cloud kites. So let's have a look where this weight is going. First of all, the leading edge is a little bit thicker on the Gong kite. You can see it over here. The Gong kite has more reinforcements on the corners. There is also extra thick, stronger klot on the corners, over here. And the Gong kite has the possibility to adjust the bridle systems over there. The Gong kite has a stabilizer in the center. And if we look at the cloud kite, then we can see there are almost no reinforcements on the corners. It's a very basic kite with a very thin klot. No adjustment possibilities. I think the main goal of board riding is to keep the kite as light as possible. The bridle system of the Gong kite is depowered. Flexible with a little control. Well, actually it's not a control. And has four entry points. And is adjustable. It's also a lot longer than the cloud kite. The bridle system of the cloud kite is fixed and has 5 points. Where the cloud kite has a fixed bridle and the Gong kite has a depower bridle. So what does that mean? Well, if you have a fixed bridle setup, the kite will react better on the rider's input. If you touch the bar, it will just react instantly. It will loop, it will turn much faster if you got a depower bridle setup like the Gong kite. And that is something I noticed. The Gong is slower than the Cloud Kite. It doesn't loop as fast, it's just a little bit slower on everything. Well, that doesn't have to be bad, but it's something that you have to take in consideration. The good thing about the Deep Power bridle setup is that it will give you a lot much higher high-end. I have surfed the Gong Kite in 30 knots on a twin tip, and the kite will just hold. It was not a problem. So let's look at the characteristics, and to come back to my previous question, is the Gong Kite a good alternative for the Cloud Kite? Well, I already said yes if you are looking for a lightweight, light wind kite for hydrofoiling, that's perfect. But to be honest, there are two different kites. First of all, the aspect ratio. The Gong Kite has a medium aspect ratio, where the Cloud Kite has a low aspect ratio. So what does that mean? Well, the higher the aspect ratio, the more power it will generate when you pull it to the power zone. So the Gong Kite has more pull when you send it to the power zone. That can give you an extra little bit of power to get your foiling. So I think that the low end of the Gong Kite is slightly better than the Cloud Kite. On the other hand, if you want to do a trick and you're standing backwards on your board and you steer the kite to the power zone, you don't want to get pulled off because you have too much power. So the power of the Cloud Kite is more gentle, let me say like this. Hang time, low wind. Well, I have tested the Gong Kite in 6-7 knots, and well, I was holding it with one hand, as you can see in this movie. And it was just holding. It's not a problem. I think you can even go lower to 4-5 knots with a little bit of looping. Again, because of the extra weight that it has compared to the Cloud Kite, it will need a little bit more wind than the Cloud Kite. But still, you can surf it in very light winds, the Gong Kite. What a relaunch! Both Gong Kite and Cloud Kite have a very good water relaunch. I would say that the Cloud Kite would relaunch better in light wind than the Gong Kite because of its weight. The Gong Kite is 0.5 kilo heavier, so I think that the Gong Kite will have needs a little bit more wind to water start in light winds. I think you can water start the Cloud Kite in any position at, let's say, 5-6 knots. And I think that the Gong Kite will need at least 7-8 knots. As you can see, the Gong Kite also has a stabilizer in the middle of the kite. I also flown the version 1 of the Gong Kites. The smaller sizes didn't have the stabilizer. And what you noticed when you are in overpowered condition, then the body of the kite tends to, well, collapse a little bit. So the stabilizer will keep the kite nice in shape. It really helps. The vel of the Gong Kite is very nice. And the vel of the Cloud Kite. I think this is the original. The vel of the Cloud Kite is the original from Cabrina. So let's look at prices. The Gong Kite at the moment that we make this video, it's at a 30% discount. You can have it for a new kite for less than 500 euros. If you are living in the US, well, you are lucky, you can buy the Cloud Kite. If you're not living in the US, you cannot buy it. But if you are living in the US, the Cloud Kite, well, if you buy only one kite, in, let's say in 8 meters, you have to pay over 1000 euros. If you buy the World Quiver, you get a discount of 25% or something on old kites. So, if you look at value for money, then well, the Gong Kite is a lot cheaper than the Cloud Kites. So guys, so far for the technicals. Let's dive into the final conclusion. The first question is the Gong Kite V2 a good kite for hydrofoiling? Well, I think so. It will hold even in 6 knots. It's got a very good low end and a very good high end. It's a lightweight kite. But if you compare it to the Cloud Kite, it's actually a totally different kite. The aspect ratio is different, the bridle setup is different, so that will make that the characteristics of the kites also are different. They both have their own strong points. The Cloud Kite is a really freestyle kite. It's got a very controlled power in the kite. It's very light. I even think that it's the lightest tube kite in the market. 1.6 kilos, that's very light. That will make that it is a very good kite to water start in light wind and to hold it with the lightest wind. The Gong Kite on the other hand is a little bit heavier, but it's built a little bit stronger, I think. Because of the higher aspect ratio, it's got a better pull, it's got a better low end, and because of the power, depower bridle setup, it's got a better high end. This is my personal opinion. If you disagree or you want to add something, please leave a comment below. Thanks for watching, guys.